How much do solar panels cost in 2024? In this video, we give you the answer with real numbers and more. I'm Warren.
And I'm Larry. And for over 15 years, Paradise Energy has helped thousands of customers control their energy costs and save money with solar energy.
It's this invaluable experience that we use to bring you an honest inside look at all things solar energy. Let's get into the cost of solar. All right, so Larry, what's the average cost of both a residential and a commercial solar array for 2024?
So obviously, tons of variables. So I'll just put that caveat out there. But just to give you an idea, residential is probably going to be in like the upper twos per watt to maybe mid threes. So if you know what your system size is, you can take that times about $3 per watt. That's going to get you close. For commercial, you're looking at probably the upper ones to the upper twos per watt. So there I'd say, you know, if you take your system size times about 250 per watt, again, that's going to get you pretty close.
So to put that in perspective, your average home that's probably got a $150 a month electric bill or so would probably need in the range of a 10 kW. So you're looking at $25,000 to $35,000 in that range for a home. On the business side, monthly electric bill of $1,500 would get you 100 kW, which would cost you what?
About $250,000 approximately, somewhere in that range. That just gives you a good idea.
Yeah.
So one more thing I'll mention, Warren, is we do have a savings calculator on our website, and we'll link it in the description below, where you can enter in your location and your electric bill, and it'll give you a pretty good idea of what you're looking at as far as costs, incentives, ROI, all those kinds of things. It'll get you pretty close.
So Larry, what goes into the cost of a solar system?
Excellent question. A lot of things go into the cost of a solar system. First of all, the installation type. Is it a roof mount? Is it a ground mount? Is it a carport? And then there's various roof types like metal, shingle, standing seam, flat roof. Those all affect the cost of the solar system. There's the type of equipment used. So what type of solar panels? Typically, we're just using the monocrystalline solar panels, so that's typically going to be very similar. But you can use an all-black panel. That's maybe more aesthetically pleasing. Inverters, string inverter versus microinverter versus optimizer. Do you need rapid shutdown? You do on a roof mount, you might not on a ground mount. You know, how does that all look? What is your energy consumption like? How much energy do you use? That affects the system size that's needed. And then how much shade and other weather variables do you have? If you have a lot of shade, you might need a bigger system, not as much shade, maybe a smaller system. And then are there any special permitting or interconnection costs to think about? And that's typically going to only be an issue on larger projects.
Sure. And so by and large, your energy consumption is the biggest driver of cost. If you don't use a lot of electricity, you're probably looking at a much smaller system. If you use a ton of electricity, you could be looking at a massive system, which obviously costs substantially more.
Definitely. Yep, that's right.
All right, Larry, so what incentives are available for going solar?
So there's a number of different ones, and some vary by state or even by county or by utility. But the basic ones would be the federal tax credit. So that's 30% for almost every project. There might be some cases where commercial projects can get more than 30%, but that's the basic one. And then some states also have state grants. Some states have tax credits. Some utilities have small incentives that you can get. Some counties will have incentives against property tax credit. So that's kind of the range. And then there's one other one for farms and small businesses, and that's the USDA grant, which right now that's a big one. That's going to be stepping down here in the coming months, but that's still going to be a pretty good size incentive going forward.
Correct. And then in addition, of course, for businesses and farmers, you can depreciate solar as well, which is another great incentive from a tax perspective.
Yep, that's right.
If you're a business leader or homeowner and want to see how solar can help you save more of your hard-earned money, visit paradiseenergy.com to request your free custom quote. In addition, our website is full of calculators, blogs, buyer's guides, and more, all designed to help you on your way to a successful solar investment. Thanks for watching, and click here to watch the next video.